As you make your way back to the pew in which you're seated, I hope you'll be the one to pick up the ritual of friendship pad. It's at one end or the other. So if you can retrieve that, we'd love to know that you were with us. So please pass that down so that you can share with others. If you look in the service itself today, you're going to see that this is Youth Sunday and it's youth-led worship today. So many of our middle schoolers have been greeting you in the back as the ushers, and they'll be working on that. You're going to hear from eight of our recent high school graduates today, and we celebrate that they'll be delivering a message to us on how they have experienced the presence of Jesus in their lives through the people and the programs here at First Presbyterian Church. Many of the worship elements have been brought back from the Montreat Senior High Conference, and so you're going to experience worship in slightly different ways, but we look forward to praising God together, and I think your hearts will be moved as our youth lead us in worship today. I'd like you to read a little bit in the bulletin at some point about the First Presbyterian Scholarships. We're going to be awarding scholarships today to several of our high school graduates, and you can read more about those scholarships. There's a detailed insert in your bulletin. We have three scholarship funds in the First Presbyterian Scholarship Program, and all of those are amazing ways for us to extend educational opportunities to our young people. So spend a little time, if you will, and review that in your bulletin. On the 18th, Saturday the 18th, we do have a need for a head cook. We are full with head cooks all the way out. Mary Beth, how many did you all serve yesterday? 120-ish? So Kaylin and Mary Beth were the head cooks. We go anywhere from 75 to 120 folks on a Saturday. We do have a group on the 18th, 10 individuals from outside the church who are coming in. So we need somebody who can work securing the food on behalf of the church and working with that group. So if you would like to be head cook on the 18th, please sign up downstairs. We're signed up for a month out after that. So thank you for volunteering yesterday, and thank everybody for helping us to continue to feed folks. Over the summer, we launched the First Pres Music Capital Campaign. And so most of the regular attenders and members receive something like that in the mail. Sending a mailing out in the summer is a risky thing to do because a lot of us had our mail picked up by other people, and we're still going through the stack of mail that came while we were away. So we have placed these in the pew racks. So if you haven't had a chance to familiarize yourself with our capital campaign, we would invite you to look through the brochure. We also have a pledge card included there. The great news is that this campaign has been underway for about a month now. The goal for the campaign is $250,000 to restore the carillon and the steeple, to do some major repairs on our organ, to help maintain our other musical instruments, and to give us $25,000 to share musical instruments and sound systems with our friends in the churches in Honduras. That's something we will do 2 years from now when we're in Honduras, is deliver that equipment. The overall goal is $250,000, and we have exceeded $100,000 in pledges to this point. So if you would like to join us in that campaign, just grab that brochure and look through. There is a pledge card included there if you need one. If you should get home and you forget about the pledge card, you can call the church office and we'll send you one, or you can go online with Secure Give and simply click from your credit card and you can make your payments right there. So thank you, but we celebrate that we've exceeded 100,000 so far, and we hope that you'll join us in this capital campaign. It is great to have all of you with us today. Let us now prepare our hearts to worship God.
Every day we go to war again. We assume we know so much more than them before we hear what they have to say. Headline breaks and we start to hate again, calling them names again. We give our peace away. I hope they see it, 'cause I wanna see it. I hope we believe it. I wanna see, I wanna see the love. Oh, all around
With grateful hearts and voices, let us rise and join in our call to worship. People of God, lift up your voice.
We are here. We are here. We are here.
People of God, lift up your voice. People of God, lift up your voice.
We come
people of God, lift up your voice. Please remain standing as we sing together from our hymn books number 401, Gather Us In.
Away, see. us the courage to enter the song. Here we will take the wine and the water. Here we will take the bread of new birth. Here you shall call your sons and your daughters, call us anew to be salt for the earth. Give us to drink the wine of compassion. Give us to eat the bread that is you. Nourish us well and teach us to fashion lives that are holy and hearts that are true. Not in the dark of buildings confining, not in some heaven light years away. Here in this place the new light is shining. Now is the kingdom and now is the day. Gather us in and hold us forever. Gather us in and make us your own. Gather us in, all peoples together. Fire of love in our flesh and our bone.
Please be seated. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, Christ, who is faithful and just, will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So, friends, I invite you to follow along with the prayer, considering the ways we have fallen short as individuals and as a community. For the times when you have failed to see your neighbor as yourself, close your eyes. For the times when you have ignored the needs of those around you, bow your head. For the times when you have pushed away someone who loves you, clench your left fist. For the times when you have silenced another by your insults or hurtful words, place your right hand over your mouth. For the times when you used your words to lift another up, open your right hand and place it by your side. For the times when you have embraced someone who needed care, unclench your left fist. For the times when you have paid attention to someone on the margins, lift up your head. For the times when you have welcomed someone just as Christ welcomes you, open your eyes. Please join us as we sing our prayer of confession.
Father in heaven, forgive me for sinning. I know I need a new beginning. Father in heaven, forgive me for sinning. I know I need a new beginning. My world is spinning. From sunrise to sunset, help me not forget all that you've done for me. From sunset to sunrise, help me fix my eyes upon your glory.
Say, oh yeah,
oh yeah,
all right,
all right.
Sunset,
sunset,
sun,
sunrise.
Oh yeah,
oh yeah,
all right,
all right.
Every sunset,
sunset,
every sunrise,
sunrise.
Ooh, I need you. Ooh, I need you right now.
Father in heaven, forgive me for sinning. I know I need a new beginning. Father in heaven, forgive me for sinning. I know I need a new beginning. My world is spinning.
Friends, look around and see the truth. You are not alone in the ways you fall short, and you are not alone in the ways that grace abounds again and again for you. No matter how many times we ignore the needs of others, Jesus Christ does not ignore us. But that also means that Christ does not leave it at that. This love that Christ has for us invites us into new life, a life that empowers us to care for one another just as he cares for us. Friends, know that you are forgiven and be at peace.
During the prayer, there will be some images projected on the screens. When you see these images, I hope that you will pray silently for what you see represented in these images. Let the Spirit guide you as you lift up your prayers. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we are reminded that we are individual members of the unified body of Christ. We come bearing the prayers of our own hearts and the prayers of others, and in doing so, are bound together as one. In trust and hope, we pray for the sick, the suffering, and the hurting. You know the ones who are close to us, and you know their needs. We also pray with joy and thanksgiving for our church, our schools, our families, and our friends. Lord, as we look at these images on the screens, please hear the prayers of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy. 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 And now, Lord, we all pray together the prayer that you taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine's kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
God has blessed our church in so many ways. Today, we are celebrating the blessings he has given to the youth and its ministry. Our youth program has thrived through the generosity of time, talent, and funds. Now, let us continue to show our support of the church and its ministry by giving the tithes and our offerings.
You hovered o'er the waters and o'er the deepest depths. You pulled us from the dust and filled our lungs with holy breath. We sing for you. But in our sinfulness, we turn our face away, and in our differences, we're divided every day. We need your truth, so we sing for you. We will lift the voice of every person, every child. God, our hearts cry out for a world reconciled. God, you call us by name. God, you weep with our pain. Oh, oh, oh. Lift every voice. You carried all our burdens. You carried all our shame, and still we find ourselves waging war and passing blame. We need your truth. The poor, oppressed, and orphaned, the broken and alone, the refugee, the hungry, all your children have a song. We need your truth, so we sing for you. We will lift the voice of every person, every child. God, our hearts cry out for a world reconciled. God, you call us by name. God, you weep with our pain. Every voice of every nation, lift every child of your creation. Lift every voice of every nation. Lift every child of your creation. Lift every voice, every child. God, our hearts cry out for a world reconciled. God, you call us by name. God, you weep with our pain. Oh, oh, oh. Lift every voice.
So, for our doxology, we're going to sing hymn number 585. But you don't really need to turn there. Just listen to the youth and repeat exactly what we say.
To God, glory to God, glory in the highest. Glory to God, glory to God, glory in the highest. To God be glory forever. To God be glory forever. Alleluia, amen. Alleluia, amen. Alleluia, amen.
Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you for what it means in which to give back to your church and its ministries. Thank you for the love that this congregation shows to our youth program through your grace. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
All right. At this time, we're going to ask all of our younger Pardon me, younger disciples, to come forward. All right, and for today's time with younger disciples, we're going to be doing something called an energizer. We do this at Montreat all the time. I'll let Casey explain a little bit more.
So basically, we do these, we learn these dances in the mornings to kind of get us energized for the day. So we're going to teach you all one of those this morning. So I'd like to invite all of you to stand up, and the congregation as well, if you would like. So
adults,
go ahead, stand up.
Too.
We're gonna teach you this dance. It's a song. Some of you have probably heard the song. It's called Fix My Eyes. So basically, you know, when we're worshiping God, we want to fix our eyes on God. And we're going to go like this, all right? You're going to put your hands on your eyes like this. But then it's more than just your eyes. It's your feet and your legs and your hips and your shoulders and your head. And then we're going to do that. And then after that, we're just going to, like, wave our arms around for a little bit. And then we all like swimming, right? We're going to swim a little bit. We're going to go around in a circle. And then, you know, we've got all these problems, that, you know, all these burdens we've got that are weighing us down, but then we just got to release it all to God. He helps us out. We just let it all go. And then you're going to put your arms out in front of you like this, and then behind your friends, and like on your friend's shoulders, and we're going to sway back and forth like that. And then we're going to do the fix my eyes thing again with the eyes, and then you come up, and then like this. And then we have one more little thing where it's three steps and kick, and then back three steps and kick. We did that a few times, so that's pretty much it. So if you all want to follow along with us and want to start the music.
All right, I think we got it. Play the track.
Great job, guys. So we have one more thing we want to teach you. It's this really fun song that we did at Montreat this year. It's called My Lighthouse. So there's a few motions that go with it. You go your arms over your head like this and make a lighthouse, then you clap, and then you shining into the darkness. And then we're following Jesus, and then he's helping us. And then at the end, you just kind of wave your arms back and forth. So I think we're ready to go.
In my my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. In the questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore.
All right, so I'm going to close this in prayer real quick. So if you all want to fold your hands and bow your heads. Dear Lord, thank you for bringing us all together this morning, bringing us down here, and thank you for giving us music, giving us dancing, and giving us energy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Today's scripture lesson comes from John chapter 12, verses 20 through 21. Now among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." This is the word of the Lord.
Good morning. My name's Benjamin Garner, and I've noticed recently at this pivotal time in my life how so many things have come full circle for me. For example, I grew up watching Tim Tebow, Lewis Murphy, and the rest of the Florida Gators win more championships than a university about 2 hours northwest of Gainesville. I'm sorry I had to go there. The same mythical team I watched on TV every Saturday, I will be able to see from the stands for a discounted price of $140. Similarly, I was baptized in the same church I speak in today by the same Dr. Negley over there, and I was introduced to the same church community that would passively and actively guide me through my journey in faith. As this house of God and this spiritual community was the setting of my baptism, it now serves as a setting for my departure to pursue higher education and strengthen my faith. Although for most of my life I've lived between two homes with two different Christian communities, it was hard not to be influenced by First Presbyterian's interactive VBS, the transcending experiences at Montreat, or the insightful lessons of Sunday school. All of these branches of First Presbyterian, guided by church members, not only communicated lessons eloquently, but put actions to the principles of Christ. Nothing spoke more to me of Christ's power than participating in Saturday soup kitchen my sixth grade year. I've since participated in it as much as I can. I witnessed for the first time members of First Presbyterian and affiliated churches dedicate their time, energy, and funds to the simple act of passing out free food to men, women, and children who could not afford such luxuries I often took for granted. Jesus speaks in another verse from John 3:18. Let us not love in word or talk, but in deed and in truth. Watching members of First Presbyterian act on God's message of charity has inspired me to follow their example, and I hope to continue to enact simple actions that attest to the grace of God so others may seek him, as I did so many years ago. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Tammy O'Neill. I've been going here for a few years now, and even though I haven't been here since I was a little girl, you guys have welcomed me with open arms, and all of you have been so kind and just so great throughout these couple of years. I am personally very active in youth group, and then I'm also in praise band. Some of you might see me with praise band. and I had seen God in other ways before I came here, but I didn't really understand God before I got here. Youth group really helped with that, especially when Leonard and Elizabeth came. That's when I really started to understand God, and I really started actively seeking him. So that was really great for me, and then ever since then, I've kept on seeking him, and I keep wanting to move forward in my faith, and it's all because of you guys in the church. One thing I did this past summer with the church was I went to Honduras, and that was an amazing experience. Really, like, wow. You don't realize how much you have until you go someplace where they don't have a lot, and the smallest things make them smile. And that's what happened there. My heart was just filled with joy just seeing them. Like, I was just blowing bubbles with the kids, and they were just happy. It was amazing. And one thing I saw there was, even though they had all these hardships and all these troubles, was they kept seeking God through the hard times. They never gave up their faith. We got to spend time with the youth group there, and we played cards and we played soccer. They're really good at soccer. We're not that great at soccer. And then they joined us for some of our devotionals, and it was really nice just being there with them. And then I found myself realizing that we had a similarity. Their church is their home, and the people in it are their family, and they support each other through everything. And that made me realize how this church, over the past few years, has become my home, and you guys have become my family. So I just wanted to say thank you guys for welcoming me, and thank you guys for taking care of me, and for treating me like family. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ashley Pomuto. I've been attending this church for almost 5 years now, and I've been a member for 4. And I know that's a bit different from those of you who've had generations of families here. From the day I started coming to middle school youth group until today, my very last Sunday as a youth, I've been able to encounter and know Jesus in so many ways. Just some of the things I've been a part of here are middle and high school youth group, VBS, the chancel choir, the bell choir, and praise band. And some of the trips I've been on are the Great Escape, Cedar Kirk, Montreat, and 2 mission trips to Honduras. Now looking back, the very first time I encountered Jesus because of this church was through one of my best friends, Lydia, when she invited me to her youth group on a random Wednesday in 8th grade because she knew I didn't have one to go to. And fortunately for me, the youth group here was so warm and welcoming from the very beginning, allowing me to finally find a church that felt like home. From then on, it was really easy to get involved in the ways I wanted, and I was and still am treated like one of those who have been here their whole lives. After about a year of being here, I thought it would be cool to join the chancel choir since I love music and I love singing. And even though it was probably a bit hard for many of the choir members to believe that a 14-year-old high school kid wanted to be in choir here, they adjusted quickly and allowed me to begin exploring my passion for music and how to use it in a church setting. I was able to find a new way to encounter Jesus, and that was through music. When it came time for the Heart of Worship service to start forming, I was asked to be a part of the praise band. I was honored to be asked, and it was exciting to see it all come together. Praise band gave me yet another way to connect with Jesus and to encourage the congregation to do the same. I'm so grateful for all of the musical opportunities I've been given by this church. And those are what have inspired me to pursue a career in music ministry, and beginning in a few weeks, that's what I will be majoring in. So I just want to thank everyone here, and especially Miss Lynn, for everything she's done for me. So thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Sean Ivey. First Pres has been my home away from home for my entire life. I mean, from being in Sunday school as a little kid through attending youth group in my middle and high school years, I have practically grown up in the church. There are so many people in this church who have helped me to grow in faith. I would like to personally thank some of them this morning. Dr. Harvey, you started my involvement in the church through various church plays throughout my life, from Miss Fanny's Hat to Twas the Night Before the First Christmas. Thank you for always supporting and believing in me. When I was a freshman in high school, I was asked by David Brinson to play with the Presbyterians. I had no idea at the time that I would still be playing with them almost 5 years later. Thank you, Mr. Harris, Squire, Lynn, and Dr. Kuhn for always encouraging me. You make playing with the Presbyterians so enjoyable. It is an honor to have been asked and to still have the privilege to play with professionals. Finally, I'd like to say thank you to Leonard and all the volunteers that have made my last year of youth group so great. Our youth program at this church has really impacted my life and taught me how to grow in faith and see Jesus with my peers. From climbing up to the steeple with Dr. Negley to attending my last year at Montreat, this program has undoubtedly had the largest impact in growing my faith in God. Another First Pres program that has helped me to know Jesus is the Soup Kitchen this church hosts every Saturday. Providing a hot meal to those who would be going hungry without it is guaranteed to bring a smile to anyone's face. There's just something about doing the Lord's work that always leaves me satisfied. Now, a couple years after David asked me to join the Presbyterians, Lynn asked me to be the drummer in a new group that would be called the Praise Band and would lead the new Heart of Worship service. At first, I was very hesitant to accept Lynn's generous offer, but as I thought more about it, I realized this would not really be a job because I'm doing what I love to do. This church and all the people in it have been so great to me and have helped me to see Jesus in so many ways. For that, I will forever be grateful.
Good morning. My name's Lydia Rennie, if you didn't already know, and I've been attending First Pres for almost my entire life. Ever since I was a little girl, starting out in Christ Kids, this church has really been my family. As a kid, I always looked forward to coming to church. The Sunday school classes and Christ Kids helped to introduce me to my faith. Thinking back, I can remember my fifth grade Christ Kids class with Ms. Pumpkin Smith and how her faith, even as a 10-year-old girl, had kickstarted my walk with Jesus. The next year, my first year in middle school, I was terrified of moving up to youth group. When confirmation came around, I really was placed outside of my comfort zone. I didn't know anybody. And I was encouraged to speak and learn about my faith in ways that I had never done before. Like I said earlier, this church is my family. In so many ways, you all have taken me under your loving wing, and you have shown me what it means to be a faithful and loving child of God. You all have given us youth the opportunity to see Jesus through the environments where we worship, to eating Sunday lunches and having praise band rehearsals. I have gotten the chance to experience Jesus in a completely unique way. Going off to college is a scary step, but I'm sure that through this church and with the help of each and every congregation member, I have built a faith and a foundation that has set me up for a lifetime. This past year, I have had so many mixed emotions about this next chapter of my life. I've been scared, excited, anxious, and everything in between, but now I can say I'm confident. This congregation, and specifically the adults that have worked with us, have shown me what it means to be a Christian. And I know that wherever I end up and whatever I end up doing, I will always have my church family here to love and support me just as you have for my entire life. Thank you for helping me see Jesus.
Hello. My name is Sadie Owen. For as long as I can remember, I've been a part of this church. I started out in the nursery, and as I grew older, I began helping my parents out in the library. I then moved on to Christ Kids as well as VBS, and soon I became involved in middle school youth group. As a middle schooler, I took part in activities such as Soup Kitchen, Cedar Kirk, and Great Escape. Before I knew it, I was a part of high school youth group. These were the most impactful spiritual years of my life. I attended the annual trips to Montreat. I went on 2 mission trips to Honduras. I began working in the nursery that I once attended, and I was a member of the search committee that brought to you Reverend Sarah Bishop. Through these experiences, the people in First Pres have demonstrated Christ's word and nurtured my faith every step of the way. While attending Montreat, I witnessed Jesus every day through the fellowship between old friends as well as strangers, soon to be new friends. He can be seen through the welcoming nature and the friendship displayed by friends and strangers alike. In assisting on the Honduras mission trips, Jesus can be seen absolutely everywhere. The deeds done by the mission team, the smiles of the grateful families, the bonds created between the youth and the Hondurans. Everywhere I looked in Honduras, I found Jesus. While I worked in the nursery, the works of Christ were made evident as I watched and interacted with the children. Their creative minds, kind words, and fun-loving spirits demonstrate Jesus every Sunday morning. In serving on the search committee, I found Jesus in every one of the kind souls sitting around the table. Through getting to know these folks, I got to know Jesus. Being able to work alongside these people and getting to hear new ideas and new perspectives was an experience that led me further on my walk of faith. Knowing that this group was working so hard to help the congregation in finding a new associate pastor, I felt I was in the presence of Jesus. In the next couple of weeks, I will be moving my journey of faith to Orlando as I attend the University of Central Florida this fall. I look forward to experiencing Jesus in new ways. Therefore, I would like to thank Dr. Negley and Leonard for leading the youth on their journey of faith. I would like to thank all of the adult volunteers for offering their time and their talents in order to support the youth. And I would like to thank this entire congregation for providing endless support and encouragement.
Good morning. My name is Casey Ray. I have been coming to the 11 o'clock service at this church for pretty much my whole life, with the exception of those summer months when there would only be one service at 10, and any Sunday after a Florida State home game. In fact, I was born at 2 a.m. on a Sunday morning, and you better believe I was with my family on the front row of the balcony 9 hours later. Okay, maybe that's a slight exaggeration, but I would definitely still consider myself to have been raised in this church. I owe so much of who I am today to this place. I feel as though the church and our church family have helped shape me just as much as my family and my education have, and that is something I will never forget. First Pres truly runs in my blood. I was baptized right there, right over there on Christmas Eve. I sat right down here for hundreds of children's sermons, and I really like to talk during them, or so I've been told. I've helped cook meals in the kitchen right below us for the soup kitchen over at the 737, and I'm sure many of you are surprised to see me up here, not in the balcony where I normally live. The scripture read earlier, which is also right here on a plaque in front of me, states, "We wish to see Jesus." And this church has helped me to do just that. One of the most significant ways it has helped me to see Jesus is through my involvement in our youth group. Having that interaction with other young people of faith has helped me in my journey by giving me a great support network as well as lifelong friendships, and I am forever grateful to First Pres for providing that. Additionally, I know I speak on behalf of all the youth when I say that I am so thankful for the seemingly endless support that this congregation has given us. The fact that I have this opportunity to speak to you all today as part of our Youth Sunday is a testament to that wonderful support. I believe this church has helped me to see Jesus the most, however, through our youth group summer trips. There is nowhere that I have ever been that I felt the presence of God like I do at Montreat. It is such a beautiful place, and the week spent there every year is a real mountaintop experience. We meet youth from all over the country who have also come to worship God, and we form lasting bonds with people over the course of a few days. I'm so appreciative of this church for giving us the chance to go on trips like this and grow in our faith. Each and every one of you in the congregation have helped me to truly see Jesus and understand what that means, and taught me so much about being his disciples. Over the course of these 18 years, you've given me the tools to take my faith into the world, some great memories, a lot of love, and a place that feels like home. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you.
Here's what I get for being so prepared. Good morning. I'm Aurora Walker. You probably recognize me as one of the vocalists on our praise and worship team, or as I like to call us, the Presbyterians. Maybe you remember me as one of the wonderfully talented people who participate in our annual talent show. You might remember me serving you at a fundraiser, or maybe every time you see me, you can't help but remember that shy little girl in Christ Kids or in Sunday school. Maybe you've just seen me around at Publix. My point is, I've grown up in First Pres for longer than I can remember, and I'm proud to call it my home. Most kids my age play sports or are involved in volunteering clubs or tutoring at their school. Not me. I do church. Don't get me wrong, it could be far worse. I spend loads of time here, and I love it. Always being involved at church has given me something to look forward to, and it's given me some of my favorite memories. The reason these experiences stand out so much to me, whether it be one of our trips to the Great Escape, or Montreat, or memories of working VBS, or even serving at the Saturday soup kitchen for my confirmation class, is that not only are these things so much fun for me, but they're spiritually fulfilling. Sometime between my very first Sunday here and now on my last official youth Sunday, I realized my calling to youth ministry. It may have been my late nights interviewing candidates for youth director or seeing youth interact at Montreat. Regardless, I am happy, dare I say downright delighted, to announce that I will be pursuing both youth ministry and voice at Florida Southern College in Lakeland in just 2 short weeks. They grow up so fast, don't they? And yes, that means I will still be a regular attender at First Pres, but it doesn't make me any less grateful to each and every one of you for being part of my family here at First Pres and for your endless support. I speak for myself and on the behalf of my peers and my family when I say I really can't say it enough. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Generally, I will close a sermon with these words, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Incredible words, and we thank you so much for sharing with us today. As you looked in the bulletin earlier, I asked you to look at the thing about memorial scholarships. First Presbyterian Church of Winter Haven does support youth in so many different ways. We care about our young people, and we celebrate when they leave us and move on into the world. A number of years ago, Bob Hines, a member of our congregation, wanted us to create a memorial scholarship fund, and he gave the seed money to do just that. Over the years, he continued to add to that, and so that has become the money from which the interest generates the C.A. Hines Scholarship. And you'll see something about Bob's father, Mr. C.A. Hines, and why he wished to memorialize him. It's printed in your bulletin. A few years after that, Bob Baker's family decided upon his death to do something to continue to let Bob's memory live on in the lives of the young people of our church. And they gave money to create the Bob Baker Scholarship Fund. You can read more about that and what Bob wished to move on in life that way. And then recently, Jay Gray and his sister Kay have established a fund that is a memorial fund to their mother and an honorary scholarship for their father. And it's the John and Mary Gray Scholarship. That is administered through the Community Foundation here in Winter Haven. I think it's GiveWell now is the name of the foundation. This year, we had a challenge at the church. We give scholarships every year and have since about 2011. This year, if you remember, on Senior Recognition Sunday, we had 20 high school graduates this year in our congregation. You saw 8 of them and heard 8 of them up front sharing their testimony with you. Others have been involved in and out of this service. Incredible young people. Now, the challenge for us was many of these young people took time to fill out the application for the First Pres scholarships. Now, the scholarship committee is Jackie Duggar, who was a guidance counselor for years, Bob Hines, Leonard Messias, director of youth ministry, and me. And we had 8 outstanding young people apply for scholarships this year. Generally, we give 2 C.A. Hines scholarships, 1 Bob Baker scholarship, and a Gray scholarship. But we were able, because we didn't have that many applicants last year and because of the generosity of the Gray family this year, to give a scholarship to all 8 of the seniors who applied for a scholarship. And we thank you for that. The minimum amount of these scholarships is $500. The money is sent to their university. It can be used for tuition. It can be used for fees, because remember, that's the way they've dodged things in the state of Florida. They raise your fees and cap your tuition. It can go to fees, tuition, or books. And so I'm going to ask Leonard to come forward, and he is going to present our First Pres scholarships today.
Hello.
Okay, good morning. Let me just say that it is a privilege for me to hand out these scholarships, and I just want to let all the young people know in here, you know, I've been at this church for 1 year, but what they did is welcome me. They did an excellent job of just making sure that when my wife and I came here, that we felt welcome. And I just want to say I really appreciate you guys for that. And of course, to every senior, we're going to miss you so much. We're going to miss you so much. It's going to be a different youth group, but to the church body, I also want to say this. The most perfect example of unity within the body of Christ is seen in the Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. But when these young people stood up here this morning, they gave you a small glimpse of what that looks like. And if anything, I hope you can take that away as you continue to support our youth program. So I am honored to hand out these scholarships, and when I announce your name, please come forth. Casey Ray. Ashley Premuto. Sadie Owen. Madeline Scammerhorn may be in the nursery, but you can give her a round of applause, yes. Sean Ivy, my neighbor. Tamara O'Neill, or Tammy as she prefers. Lydia Rennie. And last but not least, Aurora Walker.
Thank you, Leonard. Before the service is over, we still have a hymn, but I want to thank Leonard for his work in ministry here and also all of our adult volunteers. So if you have assisted in youth ministry in the past 5 years and been involved in these children's lives, Leonard, would you stand? Elizabeth, would you stand? Would you stand and join them? So if you'll look around the sanctuary today. We thank you so much. Our church functions under what's called a two-adult rule, and that means no activity with people under 18 happens with a single adult. So every Wednesday night when the Student Center is open, every Sunday morning or Sunday night when we have activities, and all these other things, the trips that you've heard about and every encounter, there are always two adults involved. And so we thank you so much for what you've done to support our youth ministry and our youth group. I had a chance to be at the rehearsal yesterday, and so I had a glimpse of what worship would be today. You have far exceeded anything I imagined you could do in helping us praise God. As we conclude our worship today, let's stand and turn in our hymn books again to hymn 339. Lift every voice and sing.
Every voice and sing, to let them deaf and mute.
I've told you over the years, many times being in a Florida church, I'll have friends from seminary that live in other places that ask me to describe this church in a retirement mecca. I tell them that we are a multi-generational church. We are blessed by the folks that we have in our congregation at 90 years and over. We are also blessed by the children that are a part of our congregation. And as you see today, we're blessed by the youth of our congregation. You've heard me say many times over, the reason we do ministry with children and youth is because it is always true that the Christian faith is one generation away from extinction. What you heard today is proof again that extinction is not coming soon to First Presbyterian Church or the Christian faith. So we praise God for what you've done, and we praise God for the lives of the young people we've been a part of. And we praise God that the message goes out as in our lives we show people Jesus. Now, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit abide with you now and forevermore. Amen.